Welcome to our How Learning Works module on the how of learning. Learning and memory are closely related. Learning, simply put, is the acquisition of new skills or knowledge. Memory is the information processing system that allows your brain to store, catalog, and retrieve the skills or knowledge you've acquired and provides a context that helps it all fit together. Memory is composed of three stages: sensory memory, working memory, and long-term memory. Sensory memory relates to how the brain takes in the information provided by the senses, most often what you see and hear, but can also include what you taste, smell, and feel. Sensory memory retains that information briefly for just a few fractions of a second. It's a short but important first step to learning. Information that passes through the senses must be actively processed or it's lost. When paired with active attention, information can make its way to the next processing stage. Working memory. This is what enables us to remember and manipulate chunks of information for short periods of time, unless we practice or work with the information. If learners make a conscious effort to rehearse whatever information they've obtained, they're more likely to be able to remember, recall, and apply that information later on. This brings us to long-term memory. Once we have repeatedly and meaningfully engaged with the information, it's effectively coded into long-term memory, where it's stored forever. Information processing is closely tied to so many of the cognitive tasks that academically successful students engage in, including the ability to effectively concentrate or the ability to extract and apply relevant information. Consciously and purposefully practicing the information is crucial for our ability to understand what we are thinking and learning week after week, semester after semester, and year after year. Practice, when it comes to meaningful learning, involves action, repetition, feedback, and reflection. While watching and listening introduces information into the brain, it's the doing that moves the learning process forward. Consider a skill you have, whether it's playing a sport or instrument, speaking multiple languages, or even painting. Would you have developed that skill if all you did was watch and listen? Remember, information must be worked more than once for it to be encoded long term. In other words, repetition creates memory. However, it's not only repetition, rather working hard with a goal or purpose in mind. With purposeful repetition, you will remember more and more, therefore forgetting less and less. Sharing and discussing different ideas and perceptions deepens critical thinking and understanding, which allows a learner to get to the next level of performance or understanding. Feedback can also help build confidence as well as awareness of what areas need more review and practice. Some examples of feedback activities include studying in groups with peers from class or working regularly with a peer tutor from the Learning Commons. When attempting to learn, repeatedly checking for understanding and competence is a vital part of the process. Ask yourself questions along the way such as, how am I doing? What is it I know and can do well? What am I finding to be challenging or do not know? College students need to be able to learn several subject concepts or skills in the same semester. Rote memory entails learning through repetition without gaining a deep understanding. While there is some value to remembering key terms and other information, it's important to note that in college there is far less rote memorization than in high school, as learners need to be able to apply and make meaning of information. The following approaches will engage meaningful memory and help you make the most of your practice time. Retrieval practice involves intentionally trying to go get relevant information in our brain to apply in the present. Each time we retrieve, our memory of the information becomes stronger. For example, instead of just reviewing concepts from the most recent week of class, ask yourself, what information or concepts from earlier in the class are related to this, and can I remember and explain those concepts? Try to retrieve the information from memory at first, and then use your resources like class notes, textbooks, or other websites to fill in the rest. Interleaving entails mixing up the kinds of problems, equations, or scenarios during your practice session. Interleaving assists with retrieval and also helps to avoid the trap of familiarity. For example, if the learner does 10 of the same kind of problems during one study session, they become comfortable with the process, and the familiarity sends the message, I know this stuff. Interleaving different kinds of problems, like shuffling a deck of flashcards, forces the brain to consider context. Which rule or procedure do I use in this situation? Thank you for joining us as we discuss the how of learning. Now that you have a broad overview of how memory works and the type of active practice that will improve memory and recall, I hope you'll join us as we dive into specific active strategies you can use to enhance your learning in the next sub-module, Make Your Learning Work for You.